Hi everyone, in this video, we are going to talk about how to draw function curves. So I have found drawing function curves very helpful because it can actually help us see the increasing or decreasing trend of the functions. It also gives us some ideas about whether we are going to get its maximum value or minimum value. So when I have a function, when I want to know like the decreasing or increasing trend of that function, I tend to draw the function curves to have a first look. So the two ideas we are going to use here, one is called plot function, the other one is called curve function. So we are going to use these two methods to draw function curves. So my first example here is called, maybe let's draw a function about y equals x to the power 3 plus 2x minus 5. So suppose this is our first function to draw. So then I'm going to write my equation 1 and I let it to be a function about x. And then I'm going to do x to the power 3 plus 2 times x. Make sure you have the star in there, minus 5. And I'm going to run that so that my function 1 is defined. And then I'm going to let x equals 100 numbers from 1 to 100. Run that. And then I'm going to let my y equals equation 1 value with x plugged in. So that means for each x value, I have a value for y in this function. So I can run that. You can see y is also a list of numbers with 100 numbers. So then I can plot that function out using plot y tilde x. So you can see the function, the plot is actually on the right side. If you want it to look better, you can actually assign the type equals L, so that is a smooth line. And another way to do it, if you want to be more flexible about your x choices, you can also let x equals a sequence. Maybe you let it start from 10, goes to start from negative 10, goes to 10, and you let it increase by 0.5 each time. So you can run that x. X is now defined as from negative 10 to 10, and each time you increase it by 0.5. So then you can define your new y on the same equation, but plugging in the new x value. So it's equation 1, so eq1 of x. And then you define your y, same length, 41 values for x and y. Then you can plot your new x and y. And then you can let the type equals L. So that is a clean line like that. So you can see if you draw the values from 0 to 100 only, you are seeing the function is increasing all the time. But if you draw it from negative values to positive values, you can see that curve is actually increasing, slow, increasing fast. Then there is a kind of a platform and then increasing faster. So you can see the bigger picture there. Okay, so then let's use the curve function for this. So same thing, I'm going to draw the function in this way, but I'm going to use the curve function in R. And first of all, you want to type that function as the first parameter, minus 5. So this is my curve function. And if you look at the description there, like every time you type a function, you can see the yellow area, it said what parameters you need to assign and how would you use that function. So you can see that, or you can just run question mark on that curve function, and then you're going to get a little help on the right side here talking about what this function is and how should you use that function. Like this is This is an example and similar to the plot function here. And there are more examples in the bottom here. You can see where you can use curve function. So, but here I'm going to use let. So you can look at the parameters you need to assign from and to. So I'm going to use from equals negative 10, to equals 10, and then I let the type equals L. So let's see. See, this is the curve function where you can put that function directly and you assign from and to, and then you assign type equals line so that you are getting the similar curve as we got in this function here. And this function is more, it is more helpful to draw the function curves, especially you have a more complicated function. For example, if I have a function with x plus 3, and on the bottom I have square root of x plus maybe minus x to the power 2 plus 1. So if I have a more complicated function, it's hard to tell how it is increasing or decreasing. So if I use curve function, then I can just copy everything in that function, and then I assign the values to make it has a larger range. And then let the type equals L. So you can see, let's see the right side there. So it said the NA values produced because square root of X, X cannot actually be negative numbers. So for this one, maybe we can from 0 to 100 and run that function. So if you zoom that picture, you can see the function takes values when x equals 0 to 100, and that function like goes up very quickly, drops down, and then goes up, and then it's kind of closer and closer to 0 as x increases. And you can also check the values if you are getting the values that are making sense. For example, if you let x equals 50, and then you run that function and see what value it gives you. So you can see when x equals 50, you are getting a negative number that is close to 0. And you can also check when x equals to 2, run that line, and then copy this function and see what value you have there. You have negative 3. So you can see it matches with the graph there. And that's about it. Thank you.